Well, made it to Dallas. A bumpy but otherwise uneventful flight. I'm off to Terminal D to visit the big Admirals Club there. I think I'm going to take something called the Sky Bridge. I have no idea what that is. Let's find out.
For some orientation about Dallas-Fort Worth, I arrived at the red dot and I'm going to the blue dot. So I can take the Skylink clockwise or anti-clockwise. But as I was walking through the terminal, I found something called the Skywalk. Skywalk will take you between C and D, and it appears there's also one between A and B.
I've never done this before, and actually had no idea that this existed. Well, that was super easy to get from one side of the airport to the other. Quite a bit faster than the Skylink. Now I just have to find the Admirals Club, which I don't remember where that is. I think it's straight ahead. And if I remember right, down this aisleway here. And it's at the other end. Here it is, we're past the coach store. Couldn't quite remember, but yeah. This is my favorite Admirals Club in Dallas. It is also the biggest. Great views of the ramp.
Full selection of hot and cold beverages in the Admirals Club. Snacks. Some really bruised up bananas. Hot food for all. Hot food is a new development since the last time I was at a club, and it's very welcome.
The airplane was cold. Had some gluten-free soup and some hot tea. Try to warm up. Tail getting old. All done at the Admirals Club. I've got, I don't know, 20 minutes till boarding is supposed to begin. My departure gate is C37, which the walkway that I got over here with isn't really convenient for, so I think I'm gonna ride the Skylink back around. As you ride up the escalator, you can feel the heat because the Skylink is outside. It's hot outside. I don't know what it is. Probably mid-90s in Texas in September. That's probably pretty normal and hot. For what it's worth, that's not really a complaint. I've been kind of cold all day. I enjoyed the, 90 degrees and 60% humidity of Florida these days. Who knew?
This train is departing.
It actually took a little longer than I thought. Boarding is scheduled to begin in 3 minutes. Maybe I'll be able to walk right onto the airplane. Stay tuned, find out next. I could have got some better food for me down here. Damn it. Well, let's take a look. Hard-boiled eggs. I'm supposed to get food on the airplane here that's gluten-friendly. So I'm gonna pass. I have a banana just in case. That's some easy to see signage.
At this time, we won't lose any additional time of the boarding process to board flight 1482 and service to Boise.
We're up to group 3.
We now welcome those in group 4 to board flight 1482 and service to Boise here at C37.
Expedited boarding. T two checkers. We've got a half hour till departure. I don't know what they're doing. Toilets don't flush. First time I've ever gone down the ramp just to come back up the ramp. And they haven't told the folks that are lined up that they can probably go back and sit down. So I'm not real sure why they're letting them stand over there.
Well, the plane is sitting. I don't see any mechanics. It's just interesting. Maybe they fixed it. I see the pilot next to the boarding door. Oh, sorry. But I take this opportunity to go down to the War's Head shop. Grab some. Grab some salami, little meat snack before getting on the plane, just in case.
They just told everybody to, they could take a seat, and they will be updating us every 15 minutes or so. So that's not a good sign.
This could suck.
The current estimate is an 8:55 p.m. departure, so that would be an hour and 10-minute delay. Maybe it'll be sooner, they say. Any of you ever get a delay that is resolved sooner rather than when they say? I never have. If you have, comment below. Well, they decided to call it, and they're going to send us to A21 for a different airplane. This aircraft is now distant from Milwaukee, so passengers headed to Milwaukee, good luck. Hopefully they get the bathroom fixed before then, but I'm off to A21.
Like the Skywalk, the Skylink is up a level. There's two stations on each of the terminals. Get you close to whatever gate you need to get to. In my case, I was going a couple stops down on A. Took me a little bit of time to get there because of the longer train ride. But zippity doo dah, there's A21.
I guess this is serendipity. When I left Boise, the America West was parked next to me, and I'm going home on America West.
Welcome aboard, group 2, welcome aboard.
Man, please not allow them
before
them. I'm lying. How's it going? Yes. Out of there for a minute.
Alright.
That wasn't very nice.
I feel like I've done this already. Weird.
Hi, how are you?
Peachy. How are you?
I'm also peachy.
We are on the America West. Let's see, Rachel is our flight attendant here in first class, and she said she's going to take care of us. She was able to get my gluten-free meal transferred over, so that's a good one for them. I got to get that note back to American, because that's pretty sweet. She got transferred from the other airplane, so thank you very much.
Our flight attendant, Rachel, certainly took good care of us. Starting me out with a gin and tonic, which was lovely. I guess you'd call that a double gin and tonic? I don't know. Something I haven't seen for a long time, a hot towel. Service included the warm nuts.
That was pretty good. We had some chicken and some fruit. And call that a sesame seed. Regular salad thing. Yeah, that was pretty good.
even with all the disruptions caused by an airplane change, Rachel is just amazing. Great service up front. I had forgotten how much more of a pleasurable experience flying in first class with an awesome flight attendant is. Kudos, American. You're doing a great job. I'm having a great flight. Of course, a couple gin and tonics doesn't hurt either.
Well, that's all for today. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that reminder bell. I'll be back next week with another trip report. And you can catch me on Fridays at 10 Mountain Time. I don't know where you are, so I don't know your time zone. But 10 Mountain Time, I'll be doing live streams talking about travel and travel news. Until next time, happy travels.